Loyola University, where he was awarded a BA in history. Apparently, he loved the university so much that he continued his postgraduate work at Loyola, resulting in his being awarded a law degree. Alderman O'Connor's children, of which there are five, all attended Hawthorne Scholastic Academy, a CPS school. His wife, Barbara, is also a longtime resident of the area, and she also taught school in the early years of their marriage. She is now a successful real estate broker. In addition to being the 40th Ward Alderman and Ward Committeeman for over the past 30 years, Alderman O'Connor has served as the Chairman of the Committee on Education for over 20 years. He is currently the head of the Committee on the Workforce Development and Audit for the City of Chicago. The Alderman is also a member and past chairman of the prestigious National League of Cities located in Washington, D.C. And he serves as the Director of Council on Youth Education and Families, which is a subcommittee of the League. When we were considering individuals whom we would like to ask to be our keynote speaker and first speaker for the National Junior Honor Society, Alderman O'Connor's name was really the only one considered. He is a strong believer in public education. Case in point, the fact that Northside College Prep is in the 40th Ward. While other aldermen did not want the selective enrollment school in their ward, Alderman O'Connor welcomed it with open arms. Northside College Prep is not only one of the most prestigious high schools in the city, it is one of the most prominent in the nation. Alderman O'Connor has always been a strong supporter of Jamieson. His presence here this evening is a testimony to how important he feels this occasion is to not only the students, but the school and ultimately the community. Without further ado, it is my great pleasure to present to you Alderman Patrick J. O'Connor.
Nice introduction.
Mm-hmm. Thank you very much for those kind words. I hope that my few remarks bear out your glowing introduction. I will tell you that I'm honored to be here this evening. And when I found that this was the first class of inductees into the National Honor Junior Honor Society, I wanted to understand better exactly what I was attending. I wanted to understand better what you have done to deserve this honor. And so, Principal Bauman and members of the Jamieson community and students and parents, when I began looking today at what the National Junior Honor Society was, I found that it was started about 8 or 9 years after the National Honor Society was started back in the 1920s. In the 1920s in this country, education, like today, was something that was always a flashpoint, because it was always wondered whether public education was succeeding to the level that people had expected it to succeed. And the National Honor Society was formed to recognize students at the high school level, in the upper classes, that had performed in an exemplary manner. And about 8 or 9 years later, they really thought hard and thought, well, what about the grades below? Because you don't just become an exemplary student in your later high school years. That's done through hard work and great training in your earlier years. And so the National Junior Honor Society started. National Junior Honor Society actually is harder to get into than the National Honor Society, because it requires one more element than the National Honor Society requires. The National Honor Society requires scholarship, good grades, requires service, it requires leadership and character. The National Junior Honor Society requires those things, and it also requires citizenship. And those are the primary elements that comprise this honor that these inductees are receiving this evening. It's interesting because for many students in most schools, making the honor roll is the ultimate thing. But for you students, cost of admission to be considered to get into the National Junior Honor Society. It is expected that you will all be good students. That's a given, or you couldn't even begin to be considered for this honor. But the other things that are combined in considering your membership in the society, and you should understand that this is a membership that is nationwide. There are chapters of the National Junior Honor Society across the country. It is a great honor that's being bestowed upon you this evening, and not one that is bestowed lightly, but one that you've earned. When you consider service, the consideration is service without compensation. It is service for others, for basically the reward of the good feeling that service gives one when they try and help people and help their community. Leadership, that's your ability to inspire your friends, your peers, to make them feel like they would follow you on a course of action or a course of conduct. And that is a quality that stands out throughout your life. If you can inspire others to a course of conduct, if you can inspire people to follow you, you have great potential. Character. We all know a few characters. I know when I was in grammar school, I was considered a character. But not in the way I think we'd like to consider you guys. You have a character that is full of integrity, honesty, compassion, and most importantly, respect for yourselves and others. It's amazing to me how more and more as I get involved with young people and as I was involved with the education committee, the word respect is given so much more attention from young people today than it was when I was a kid. We didn't grow up expecting to be respected by adults. We didn't grow up expecting to be respected by those who were older than us. It was our job to respect them. Young people have the equation correct, though. Respect is a two-way street. And part of what you expect from others is what you give to others, at least in terms of this award that you're receiving tonight. Your character has a great respect for yourself and for those around you. And then citizenship, which was particularly important to me being in government. Because government needs people that recognize that the role of government, particularly in a democracy like the United States, really needs to have a farm team. We really need to recruit young people to really begin to consider being involved in citizenship, being involved in their community, at whatever level they can be involved. Not everybody needs to be an elected official. Not everybody needs to be a commissioner of a department. But everyone who lives in a free democratic society has to be prepared to spend some time helping their community maintain its good qualities and improve those that need to be improved. Tonight, we recognize in a special ceremony, a special evening, a special event, which is a requirement, actually, of the National Junior Honor Society. This isn't something that your teachers can pass out in the classroom. It requires an event like this because ceremonies often bring attention to the fact that there is an important part of this honor that you're receiving. It doesn't come without responsibility. You are the first group of inductees in Jamieson. So forever, anyone who gets inducted into the society will be following your lead and hopefully following the fine example that you will set as members. You will be the people that will inspire others to want to follow you into this society. And you will be the people who will take this honor and hopefully regain it as National Honor Society members when you get into high school. It is a great honor and also a great responsibility. And the one thing that I am confident in is that all of you sitting here this evening know that you just didn't get this way by yourselves. You know that it didn't just come from sitting around and watching television or playing video games or hanging around with your friends. It came from a lot of hard work, not just by you, but by your parents, by your teachers, by all of the staff and faculty at Jamieson School, and wherever you go to receive education and input into your growth. process that you're involved in. I'm thrilled to be here this evening to be able to give you a few words of congratulations, because for me, this first class is the beginning of another important step that Jamieson takes to being the type of school that everyone in this city is proud of. You follow a long line of great students, and there's been a long line of really good teachers and good principals in this school. But you have upped the ante. From this point forward, this society becomes another part of what is important about Jamieson and what is good about Jamieson. And so I want to congratulate you all. I want to encourage you to sometime this night, show the character that I know you all have, and thank your parents and others who have helped you to get here. This is no small accomplishment, and they really take great pride, but also deserve a great part of the credit for who you are and who you are becoming. In this city, we try very hard to encourage our young people to be involved in community. You are the ones that help set that tone. So congratulations to you all. Congratulations to the principal and parents. Thank you very much.
Scholarship denotes a commitment to learning. The student is willing to spend hours in reading and study, knowing the lasting benefits of a cultivated mind. We should continue to learn even when formal education has ended. For human education ends only with the end of life. Knowledge is one great element of life which leads to the highest success, and it can be acquired in only one way, through diligence and effort. Learning furnishes the lamp by which we read the past, the torch guiding us to understand the present, and the eye and the light that illuminates the future. Candidates have charge to continually expand their world through opportunities and inherit in scholarship. Where many opportunities arise to help others, both at school and in the community. A willingness to work for the benefit of those in need. Without monetary compensation or public recognition is the quality we seek in our membership and promote for the entire school.
We are committed to volunteering our time and talent to the creation of a better tomorrow.
The obligations each member of our society faces to live up to the democratic ideals given to us by the founders of our country. The responsibilities each of us has to our home community, our state, our nation, and our world are many. As good citizens, we are bound to live up to the laws and guidelines which unite us as a civilized society. Good citizens work together to improve not only our lives, but the lives of other fellow citizens. Good citizenship requires that we remain strong and vigilant in protecting the freedoms and rights that have been granted to us and in preventing injustice from entering our lives. We, the members of the chapter, are called to live to the high standards of citizenship from this forward. Character is the force within each individual that distinguishes one person from others. It gives each of us our individuality, without
which no one can respect himself and hope to obtain respect from others. It is the force of character that guides us through life. Once developed, grows steadily. Character is achieved and never received. The problem of self-control
of the National Junior Honor Society who participated in the lighting ceremony. They will step forward as I call their name. First, we have Nicole K. DeGio. Then we have Vice President Amari Santiago. We have Secretary Sophie Jian. We have Treasurer Akshara Nafala. And Sergeant-at-Arms Daria Johnson.
Higher.
Jackson. Mr. Kasim. Farhad Khan. Yuma Khan. Nina Lee. Kelly Ma. Akshara Nasala. Joanne Fan. Jeremy Rommel. Amari Santiago. Felipe Sari. Lisa Sari. And last but not least, Sabina. All right, ladies and gentlemen, if you would please rise and greet your family. And it is my great pleasure to introduce to you the first members of the National Junior Honor Society, Minnie Mars Jamieson Chapter.
I want to start off by thanking everyone for being able to come and join us tonight in this ceremony. I'd like to give special thanks to our alderman, Mr. O'Connor, for taking time out. I know this really isn't taking time out. He cherishes an opportunity to congratulate and work with young people that strive to do as well as they do. I'd like to also thank Mrs. Fager for spearheading, taking the initiative, and working and bringing this to my attention and being the sponsor of our chapter of the National Junior Honor Society. And the committee members that help select and find groups of students. I don't want to take a lot of time tonight. A lot has been said. said that I would only be repeating it, and was said much more eloquently than I usually do it. I do want to let the parents know first and foremost, the old adage is, the fruit doesn't fall far from the tree. And in this case, it definitely does not. I cannot tell you how proud I am of your children. I know you are equally and more so. I can't tell you how important it is that I, as a principal of an elementary school, have such caring and dedicated families that work so hard together as a family to promote the values that we've spoken about today that are enveloped in the National Junior Honor Society. Your help with your children allows the teachers and the people that do the work in this building to really concentrate on meaningful work. And so I want to thank all of you. You've done a phenomenal job. And if you want to bring more siblings, bring them. Bring all of them. I'm going to bring kids. And for our students, our deaf team, I am incredibly proud of all of you. Not only for what you always do and the way you demonstrate handling yourself to this building. I'm extremely proud that you've started something new, as Alderman O'Connor very eloquently did. You raised the bar on expectation of what we do here at Jamieson. Jamieson is an excellent place to go to school. And you've just made it that much better. So I'm going to ask you, beyond doing what you always do, I'm going to try to ask you one more thing dealing with community service. The community that you serve just through your leadership and your demonstration of how to behave in the building, how to cherish work, how to strive to be smarter and more engaged, and how to be excited about learning, demonstrating that to your peers, standing up and vocalizing the importance of education. I want you to continue to help the leaders in that aspect here in the building. As we all know, sometimes it's very easy to be silly and to get off task and to think that the guy in the back of the room or the girl in the back of the room is being moved, that are one to laugh at, that they're fun to be around. And they are. But you know, and you demonstrated, there's a time for that, and there's a time to be through your continued demonstration of which you engage our community, your peers, in becoming stronger, better students. And you just need to do that by example. So if you do anything else, continue to lead by example. So, again, I want to thank all of our guests tonight. I want to thank the parents for everything they have done. And to the students, it takes a group of people to help get where you are, but it's really what's in you that's gotten you this far, and that will take you far to keep it up. Thank you very much.
That's what kids do.
Wait, slow. Oh, jeez. Nice.
night.
I'm sorry.